Hello, my name's Michael and I'm the coordinator of the Prison to Community Project with the Irish Red Cross.
Hi there, my name is Anthony Breen and I'm the lead facilitator of the Prison to Community Project. You're probably asking yourself, what is the Prison to Community Project? I've never heard of it. And you know, a lot of people, when they think of the Red Cross, they think of, you know, people responding to emergency crises. They think of, you know, emergency aid. Yes, and that is some of the work that the Red Cross does. But the Irish Red Cross also deliver a community-based health and first aid program in the prisons. And the Prison Community Project is now is an extension of that out into the community. And it's basically to try and help improve health and well-being within our communities with people in the criminal justice system in Ireland.
The Prison to Community Project started in 2015 when the Probation Service partnered with the Irish Red Cross. This was based off the enormous success of the prison programme. Volunteers who have completed the CBHFA programme while in prison are provided the opportunity to facilitate workshops in the community with their peers. These workshops are peer-led and provide both participants and volunteers the opportunity to support their peers, be supported by their peers, and to grow.
And we want to build on this work moving forward in the community, the prison program. And one of the ways that we're doing that is we use lived experience as a resource. You know, because some of the lived experience that people have of the criminal justice system can be a massive resource and offer such insights and give us such an understanding into the process of why people get involved in crime, but also helping us to break away from a life of crime and actually beginning to look at a strengths-based or a strengths-focused, resource-based approach. And what we do by that, what we mean by that is when our facilitators are inside the workshop, they begin to open up about their own life experiences. And they begin to draw upon, okay, so how did I manage situations in the past? And how can we manage situations differently in the present? And what this does is this allows the barriers to come down among their peer group. And they begin to open up about what's really going on for them. To be honest with you, the workshops, we get into some real talk. And I don't know about you, but in the community, I think we need more of that. So that's why we really value the lived experience. And it's a massive resource that can contribute to improve health and well-being within our communities.
We know how difficult the transition from prison to community can be. We've heard it time and time again from the people that we work with. And what we want to do is provide a network of support so that people are supported through that transition. So at the moment, we're running three different workshops in the community. These are Culture of Nonviolence and Peace, which is run over 2 days, Peer Support Prevent and Relapse, which is run over 1 day, and Overdose Prevention, which is also run over 1 day. These are held in community-based organizations, probation-funded projects, and also in partnership with Probation Services.
So as you heard, we're embedding the Prison to Community Project this year within the Probation Service, and our longer term vision for the whole project is to, towards the end of 2024 and into the beginning of 2025, is to actually pilot, well, we're not even going to say pilot, we're going to say we're adapting and transferring our prison program into the community, because we've seen the massive impact that it's made, and there's a real appetite among community-based organizations, you know, to embed an actual like a peer support, a whole peer support network, and to actually create a platform for people to actually improve user participation and develop as leaders within their service. And it's exciting times for our project, and we're really looking forward to see, you know, how hope is going to be inspired within community-based organizations and within the wider criminal justice system as we use lived experience as a resource to inspire change.
Yeah, so this has been a very short introduction to the Prison to Community Project. Please get in touch with us if you want to have a conversation or hear more about the work that we do. Thanks for watching.
Yeah, thanks for your time. Thanks for tuning in and checking out a little bit about what the Prison to Community Project is. We've shared a little bit about ourselves, and we're looking forward to hearing more about you and, you know, your story and how you can bring your own lived experience into our workshops. So for now, take care. And all the best.